had to prove something. We had to prove that we was as good as. We had to prove that we could handle tanks, gyro stabilizers, panoramic sights, all these technical things that belong in a tank. We shouldn't have had to do it, but we had to prove to America that we did it, which was a shame.
The guys that are doing this thing, they're just fanatics on it, which is wonderful. And you know, the young kids can actually see what their granddads did, you know, and it actually comes home to them. And it, plus, it's, you know, it keeps you thinking all the time as well. So, which I love that kind of thing, you know. It's fascinating.
There's impossible options. Young men come forward to answer the call of their countries, their families, their lives.
Okay, really good. I do feel like you're rushing a bit, so you can slow down. You can slow down just a little
really
bit. And definitely you can slow down on that last line too, you know, against impossible odds. You know, you can really take your time to set up the drum.
My father was in the Second World War. He was in the desert. He fought in the desert with the desert rats and the, you know, Durham Light Infantry. And then he went to Anzio. So, you know, with every now and again, he didn't talk about it much, but every now and again, we get little tidbits, little snippets of what really happened. And it fascinated us as three small boys. We just used to hang on to every word.
So we had the speed, we had the durability, we had the tools of us, but we still didn't have the armor. We only had 4 inches of armor. The Tiger Roy had 12. You couldn't knock him out if you hit him in front. So we learned ourselves how to defeat him.
Thank you.
You had to prove her. We had to prove that we was as good as anybody. We had to prove that we could handle tanks, gyro stabilizers, panoramic sights, all these technical things that belong in a tank. We shouldn't have had to do it, but we had to prove to America that we did it, which was a shame.
The guys that are doing this thing, they're just fanatics on it, which is wonderful. And you know, the young kids can actually see what their granddads did, you know, and it actually comes home to them. And it, plus, it's, you know, it keeps you thinking all the time as well. So I love that kind of thing, you know. It's fascinating.
It's impossible option. Young is coming forward to answer the call of their countries, their families, their lives.
Okay, really good. I do feel like you're rushing a bit, and you can slow down. You can slow down just a little
really
bit. And definitely you can slow down on that last line too, you know, against impossible odds. You know, you can really take your time to set up the drum.
My father was in the Second World War. He was in the desert. He fought in the desert with the desert rats and the, you know, Durham Light Infantry. And then he went to Anzio. So, you know, every now and again, he didn't talk about it much, but every now and again, we get little tidbits, little snippets of what really happened. And it fascinated us as three small boys. We just used to hang on to every word.
So we had the speed, we had the durability, we had the tools of weapons, but we still didn't have the armor. We only had 4 inches of armor. The Tiger Roy had 12. You couldn't knock him out if you hit him in front. So we learned ourselves how to defeat it.
Thank you.
Yeah!
You had to prove her. We had to prove that we was as good as anybody. We had to prove that we could handle tanks, gyro stabilizers, panoramic sights, all these technical things that belong in a tank. We shouldn't have had to do it, but we had to prove to America that we did it, which was a shame.
The guys that are doing this thing, they're just fanatics on it, which is wonderful. And you know, the young kids can actually see what their granddads did, you know, and it actually comes home to them. And it, plus, it's, you know, it keeps you thinking all the time as well. So I love that kind of thing, you know. It's fascinating.
It's impossible how young kids come forward and answer the call of their countries, their families, their lives.
Okay, really good. I do feel like you're rushing a bit, and you can slow down. You can slow down just a little
really
bit. And definitely you can slow down on that last line too, you know, against impossible odds. You know, you can really take your time to set up the drum.
My father was in the Second World War. He was in the desert. He fought in the desert with the desert rats and Durham Light Infantry. And then he went to Anzio. So, you know, every now and again, he didn't talk about it much, but every now and again, we get little tidbits, little snippets of what really happened. And it fascinated us as three small boys. We just used to hang on to every word.
So we had the speed, we had the durability, we had the tools of weapons, but we still didn't have the armor. We only had 4 inches of armor. The Tiger Roy had 12. You couldn't knock him out if you hit him in front. So we learned ourselves how to defeat him.
Dusk under attack.
Yeah!
Obelisk under attack.